Greetings, mortals, and welcome back to the Blindness of Eternity. When last we left off, we were killing a bunch of undead. We just finished off a room full of them, and we were basically just exploring this catacombs area. We had run into a group of dead cultists, and in addition to the group of dead cultists, we know that they were cultists because we found one of their bodies still had its spirit around, and basically we found the rest of them over here where they were killed by trolls and dangers. We also found someone here who I suspect is another member of the cult, and I suspect that the cult is the same cult that we're looking for, because he had a book about a queen, and that queen was a deity, and it was called... I don't remember what the deity was called. Was it Wodica? Something like that. Some vaguely Celtish name. Anyway. We have since been exploring the catacombs and finding a bunch of undead around, which is always exciting and cool. So, we found a corpse with some other armor, which is very exciting.
Please help me here!
And then we triggered a cloud, because we're cool like that. I'm actually gonna load this. I really don't like the fact that you can't just detect traps without moving fast. To be honest, it annoys me. And yeah, I reload for traps. It's a
light,
thing.
Flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
It's particularly funny, actually, because this guy's corpse is a dead giveaway that there's a trap here. Oh, I did have...
Yeah.
Oh, she just can't detect that trap. Interesting. She's just not... She's just not observant enough to see the trap. Very interesting. So there's presumably another one here.
Yeah.
She can't detect either one of them. Where's this go? There's a Temple of Wodica over here. That's interesting. Okay, so we're not going to go this way yet because we can't detect the traps that are over there and we're going to get blown up. So... Instead, we're going to go to the Temple of Wodica. And this will be interesting and exciting to see.
Margrin's fire casts light in darkness.
Whoa, holy crap. In front of you looms the ghostly, hollow image of a man who had presented your... who was present at your awakening. He casts a pale, sickly light in the dank corridor as he regards you. You're from...
You are from Kratom, my dear.
Kratom, I think, is the place that I was from, so...
A remarkable city. Truly one of the most impressive we have encountered outside of our own. Many exceptional people who have joined our cause come from Kratom. What made you decide to join our order?
I don't know what their teachings are. Go number six.
As long as you are assured in your faith, the rest is not so important. Are you ready to take the oath to spread the word of the gods to the lost and heathen?
So she used to be
like
one of her previous souls.
Quickly and quietly.
One of these cultists. So that's good to know. Mercenary looks at you warily as you approach. What are you doing here? You don't look like one of the masked lot. Hang on, too. Since you don't know, you clearly don't belong here. Okay, well. It's probably a bad idea for you to pick this fight.
Yeah.
Rest up, big guy.
Oh, hello.
We got you back.
How long am I going to be prone for? Oh my goodness, that's a long prone. How long are you going to be prone for? Ooh, wow. Priests, telling you.
What?
Never trust them.
I'll let Godwin's fire bless this.
Really?
Hmm?
You guys are really crappy at this. Causing people to die. So that guy's dead. Now Aldrea will come over here and triple the amount of damage being done. Oh, Durant's is dead, needs a load.
No problem.
Let's see. So let's send him in first.
350.
That's interesting. So we're gonna just try to deal with these guys. This guy, rather. It's for her. Oh, sure.
Stand still.
Okay, so he's prone. He ain't going nowhere.
This thing isn't doing the job.
Let's go! Sure.
Okay, so we have access to this. Let's use it.
Stand still.
After an Ichimok.
This thing isn't doing the job.
Stand still.
Okay. So half
I think it may be
dead.
Time to strike up camp.
Really was not a good idea for this guy to attack us.
Eh?
I guess he was expecting his friends to help him from further in the depths of this temple, but that never ended up happening. So we have a mercenary, and a mercenary, and a mercenary. That is a lot of people. Holy crap. So we're gonna hopefully make them all go prone. Oh, goddammit. Really a lot of these guys, holy crap. So, he is... Why can't I target him? Oh, he's confused. Okay. Zeldra? Yes, it is. So the two of these guys are gonna take out this guy first.
What?
I'm gonna cast a blessing.
They got Sagani.
Kana, seriously? Oh, that is so irritating. Oh, Jesus. What the hell? My pet triggered the trap as well.
This thing isn't doing the job.
So let's summon up a bunch of skeletons.
On your word.
He's gonna die.
We've got your back. This thing isn't doing the job.
I'm just gonna let the skeletons fight for now. Because getting all upset because a skeleton falls over. It's like, no, skeleton! So he seems to be completely uninterested in actually defending himself against the swarm of undead. Eat Mark! Yeah. Good job, Ethan. Okay, so we've got another spell book. Anything else that we need here? Doesn't look like it.
Yeah.
I guess I probably should have taken those lockpicks. It's okay though. So
let's see what lies this way.
What the heck is this? I was not expecting these catacombs to lead to a story-based, like an important story area. I guess there's just time to get blinded. Okay, so Mercenary's Toast.
If we get some sleep.
I don't think that this mercenary's gonna have a different
laying low
thing than the other one did. And it doesn't even matter because I don't have the character that would be using it anyway. So how's our construction going? One day for the dungeons. Okay, so it looks like we already pulled most of the guys in this room.
Huh?
Who are you? Have everyone else go after. Oh, Jesus. Okay, so. Who's gonna.
What?
Shit. Okay. What's that?
What if it eats you?
Okay, so we're gonna go after this guy next.
Stand still!
I'll take a look.
Let's go ahead and loot these guys. We'll save the game. We'll loot this.
Got it.
By the deeds of my tongue and oh, that's not it.
Yes.
Okay, so the initiate's toast. We are unfortunately not learning too much here because book lies on the table, its face is filled with some kind of unintelligible cryptography. Four mechanics and five lockpicks. And I think that this is... yes. This is the same book, so we have...
this won't stop me for long.
I have 13 lockpicks.
There! Done!
She sounds so excited and chipper when she... unlock stuff. Did I set my alarm? I didn't set my alarm? Oh, I'm so sarcastic. I thought that I set my alarm at the beginning. I think it's probably been at least 15 minutes, so I'm gonna set the time for 45 minutes. And I was doing so good about that, too. Oh well. So it's interesting because when we came here, they immediately attacked us. It's not something where, like, we had to try and enter, you know, against their orders. They literally just saw us and started attacking. Which is kind of interesting because apparently there's a way to get in here in a non-hostile manner, right? Hmm? So I'm curious about that. Seems like it's gonna end very badly for me.
Job.
What the hell is that?
Hey.
Let's go.
Okay, so let's. Oh, he's using the wrong weapon set too. No wonder. Okay, so that explains a lot, actually. Let's try and knock these guys down.
Hey.
Durant needs to pull back. And we're gonna drop some skellies on these guys. Wait, what? God damn it. Okay, well, that's what happens when you completely botch things. So he didn't have his shield out, and that was a mistake, and I didn't use his other thing either. So this gives him plus light. What, 21 defense? Something really good. It's plus 21 deflection, because his axe gets plus 5.
Alright then.
So. Just keep moving. Oh shit. I was expecting these guys to turn around at some point. And they did not. We just put ourselves in a bad position. So let's. Try this again, shall we? Because the last time they ran away, so I just kind of assumed that was going to happen again. That was a bad assumption to make.
Hey.
And because of that, I put myself in a position where I was going to be in an unbelievable. Okay, there we go. This time he's also closer, which means that. Go on this guy.
Stand still.
Ready, Watcher.
Yes.
Andrea. Is where? Oh, this is Aldrea. She's the one with the weird hat. Oh, did she miss? I'd like to finish this pack off if possible, but I don't think it's very likely that I'm going to be able to clear out this entire place.
I cannot keep up this pace.
Unfortunately. And the problem is that if I try to rest at this point,
yeah,
like if I leave,
there's
serious concerns about what the implications of that are. The people will have the ability to basically leave this place and set up camp somewhere else, in addition to the potential that they will be able to track me down easier. Where are you?
Yes?
Holy shit. You got way ahead of everybody else. Okay, so. Get everybody out here. No. You stay back. You knock him down.
Yes.
He's prone for 5 seconds. We're gonna attack with everybody except him.
Stand still.
Yikes! Okay, so she needs to back out as well. So we're now down 2 party members. The other ones will have to pick up the slack. Hey, milk!
Yeah?
I wonder if it'll curdle over time. So he's gonna pop in here, and...
Yeah?
These two will do what they can.
Hmm?
It's kind of interesting. I wonder what, like, Itumak's... Because Itumak is susceptible to fatigue. And I'm curious if his fatigue is based off of his master's fatigue? Or if it's separate. This is athletics. This guy's dead set on getting to these people. Holy crap. What are you doing? Now he's not even in act? What the hell?
Sure.
This is crazy. What the hell was that? Holy crap. So that was a thing. A very weird thing.
Ready,
so we're gonna
Watcher.
Have to pull these people even further back because apparently that wasn't far enough. Like, that guy was on a suicide mission.
All
he
right,
knew
then.
He was going to die. He even went so far as to completely de-aggro when he couldn't charge after the completely arbitrarily chosen target that he. Well, I guess they weren't really chosen. I'm sure that the reason that they were chosen was because they were weak. They were low HP. Still pretty crappy, though. Alright, so... You are gonna drop these over here. Fall over. This thing is... flanked pretty crazily. Apparently mindless skeletons are susceptible to confused status effect in the system. I think they're susceptible to fear too, actually. I'm actually gonna swap this.
No!
Veranthus!
Yeah! Hey.
Okay, there we go. So we cleared this pack.
I cannot keep up this pace.
I can move along. I'm sure this would play out very differently if you'd done it in a different order. Like, there must be something you can do that will allow you to come through here peacefully. This looks promising. Shrouded man. Shrouded woman. Well, so much for the shrouded man being special. Okay. Let's save this.
We're
gonna pull these guys back. Disciplined barrage. So he's a fighter. Whoa! That guy is not a fighter, but he is very, very fast. We're gonna turn around and fight him. Well, he's not. Neither is she. Actually, I guess she is. Oh, is that a monk? I think that's a monk.
Thing is,
yes?
Yeah.
The job.
Stop. Holy crap. Head out of books and into the fight. Boy needs to get his head out of books and into the fight. It looks like we are still in combat, which means that we're gonna have to fight all of these guys in one set. It also means that we're not gonna get our knockbacks and things like that back. Shit.
No problem.
I should be pulling with the dog. Or the wolf, rather. Or the fox, I guess it is. Well, I guess that precludes the option of pulling with the pup. I'm gonna be in serious trouble here. I don't know how he moved when he got knocked over. This is going to be really very difficult with what we've got right now. Send the fox up to the pull. Because the fox does move faster than they do by default. So the fox should be able to pull safely. And there's him coming in. Okay, so he grazed with the prone effect. Holy crap! That was crazy. Yeah, I think that I'm just gonna have to leave and come back. I just don't have anywhere near the resources necessary to kill all of these guys. If they were the same power, well.
Yeah.
Okay, we will try this. We will try this one more time, I guess. I do think that it's going to be not feasible. Simply due to the fact that,
all right. Then, hey.
Yes?
I think that we should be okay to send these guys in.
Eh?
We should not be okay to send her in necessarily. Hitting pretty well considering all the defense that he has. Yikes. I'm kinda curious.
Eh?
Can I actually run far enough away that they de-aggro?
You cannot venture forth while in combat.
Nope. So, we are going to be in combat for pretty much indefinitely. I'm going to summon up some undead. We're going to use them to tank.
Thank you.
Oopsies. I've got a little too far ahead. Come here. Come here. Come on, buddy. Come on. That's a good shrouded figure. Come on. Little closer. Okay, we're gonna have to just keep him here. And then send in the undead to aggro him. You'll send her in behind. Oh crap, I shouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
Back to the wheel with that one.
So, how many spells do I have? I have quite a few of these higher level spells. I am going to. This is versus fortitude, not against reflex like I thought it was. I'm gonna do this.
Lavaro.
Guys, they're closing in on us.
Yes?
This thing has one hit left in it. I'm just gonna summon another one. Another one, I mean another three.
Fight on, my friend!
Got
this guy has 12 damage reduction, so let's try and use this.
You gotta be more careful.
We're one fewer now.
That's bad. That means this guy's gonna get an attack off on her. Please die.
On your word. Roar 10!
There we go. So he actually swapped. Whew. Okay, so. That's
no
two. But we took a bunch of damage there. I don't see any meaningful reason to believe that we're gonna be successful here. Oh shit. So we have another one of these sword guys, along with a spellcaster. The spellcaster just crit my skeleton for an insta-give. I think I'm gonna have to reset this group. And yeah, I don't think that we're gonna be able to pull this guy solo. I just got fully into our party. I'm gonna try to knock him over. And hopefully the mage will content himself.
Point the way.
Over there. Come on.
I'm here.
It's already been half the duration of this effect. He's not even injured.
What?
Should I cast a bless? I think I need to. Oh, he's not knocked down anymore. Oh, I don't have this guy dotted up with this. There we go. So, Wounding Shot is active. I can just keep hitting this person with Undead. So, there is that.
Hey.
He is not actually tanking, so I don't know what he thinks he's doing. Please. Okay, he's prone for 4 seconds. Before he gets unproned, I need to move her out. Shit. Oh no, eat the lock.
Oh good.
So that person over there is an issue. Can I? I'm not sure how this is gonna work.
All right then.
Hey.
Down by one.
So we knocked this person over.
No problem.
And I think that I kind of need to just send her in. I definitely need to send him in, because...
After him.
Plus side. Spellcaster without any melee backup isn't really that dangerous. On the negative side... As you guys can see, we are still in combat with something over there. And let's swap him over to the movement speed increaser. And let's take a look in here. So, I don't see anything. I don't want to send Itamak in there, because I'm worried that he's gonna get... There's some interesting stuff. One thing that's actually very nice is I can just draw out a boatload of spells, and since combat is not going to be dropped at any point... Oops. Are you a caster? Another fireball just came out. Holy crap. We need to get back.
Get up. Damn you. Got it.
So let's pop another cadre of skeletons. And we'll just send these in one at a time. Oh, what are you doing? No, no, no. Ooh, is she alone? This chick is alone. So we can just send him here. And we can now get everybody in here. Oops. Okay, so we can't allow this person to attack Eldrea. How many total hit points does he have left? He has 105 hit points at his disposal still. Which is good, but he's gonna be very easy to kill, so. He needs to just get back. Eldrea is in a dangerous position. This person has 12 damage reduction. Does he have a shield? If I can see.
On your word.
Hey.
Kind of feeling like I'm gonna need to.
Alright then.
Wait, this shrouded man has a female voice set.
Leave it to me!
Ooh, nice. It's a crit. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to deal very much damage here.
Ready, Watcher.
And that's a substantial problem, because... What is it? He's a cleric. No! Big no!
Following your lead.
We need to attack. We need to attack. So let's see if we can manage to take this one out. Whew. That's one more dealt with. I don't think that one would have regenerated because that was actually a cleric. I thought it was a fighter, but it was actually a cleric. And I don't think clerics will regenerate. They can heal themselves, but they have a limited amount of healing because you only have so many spellcasts. So... On the plus side, Itumak, as long as he doesn't go down, Itumak has an unlimited number of hit points. I can regenerate them with him, and he doesn't have a hit point pool, he only has an endurance pool. He technically has a hit point pool, but it's not actually used for his hit points, apparently. Okay, so this is another one of these clerics. It seems to be alone. So, I'm gonna try and fight this thing just with these for now. And see if he uses any of his abilities. I'm not actually sure whether this will be feasible, but it looks like we will be able to just recast the skeletons continually. And he's now using Turn Undead. And yes, the Holy Radiance killed them all. But that's Holy Radiant's use. Now, I don't know if he can reuse it now, because he just left combat. But I'm not sure if he even is actually leaving combat or not. To be perfectly honest. We'll see. I'll have to work under the assumption that he is in fact leaving combat. Doesn't look like it though, because he is still barely injured. Oh. That guy just randomly cast a web at his friend. Actually, I could start beating on this guy with him. And when this thing's near death, which is right now, pull him down. Recast.
Let's end this.
He doesn't actually do very much damage, so there's really not much reason to take that risk.
Fight on, my friends!
Now, this guy is still just registering as barely injured. I don't know how long it's gonna take to do this way. So, let's see. Who can we bring in? We can bring in Aldrea. She can take a hit. She can only take one, but she can take a hit. We can bring in the dog. The dog will actually be able to get in and take a couple of hits. The problem is the dog really has very few hit points overall, so it would be very easy to accidentally kill off our puppy. And we don't want to have that happen, because the puppy has, as we said, unlimited hit points, as long as we don't get it killed. Back. There we go. So we're just gonna have to weave in the puppy between attacks. It again occurs to me that the dog is heavily fatigued. So he's just used one of his spells. And he's injured. We actually have... Whoa. Oh, we have the ability to flank this guy too. Maybe I should have been doing that this whole time. So, another heal spell's coming out. I'm actually gonna cast this directly on him, see if they automatically flank. Yeah, they do. So he's used three healing spells so far. He does theoretically have a limited number of those. But he probably has quite a few since he should also have some lower level spells. Ooh, nice. 8 damage hit.
On your word.
Another 8 damage hit. Ooh, another 8 damage hit.
Yes?
If we can get it down to just spellcasters, like just the mages do not actually have much that they can do against my summons. So life will get a lot easier. So this guy is below half-life. I assume, based off the fact that he's let himself get down this low, that he does not have any more spells. So let's see. Still badly wounded. I'm just gonna pull another group up. And this will slowly but surely work out for us. Apparently you can't make time go faster while in combat. Okay, so he turned around and was actually going to attack Itamok there, but pulled Itamok out before he got a chance to. We'll need to be careful. They're closing in on us. No better place to be using this summon undead spell than in this this crypt. So he's below 20% life. And he's dead. Itamok killed him. Whew. So, that's one more cleric dealt with.
Following your lead.
I don't think that's the last cleric, though. I think that we still have another cleric in here. And we still have this guy casting webs. Interesting. It looks like we might just be down to two spellcasters. And if that's the case, that'll be really good for us. Hi. Okay, so we need to wait so that we can recast the spell. So here's the question. Are these guys getting their spells reset every time they leave combat? No, what are you doing? I don't know how that even happens. But somehow I keep targeting Aldrea. Okay, so he's just gonna get out of here. Unfortunately, this guy does hit with an AoE. Unfortunately, since this guy is using an AoE, I'm a little hesitant to bring my puppy in, but I think I'm gonna do it anyway, just because he doesn't really have much defense. He doesn't hit very hard with his individual attacks, and I just feel like a little bit of damage on the pup is fine. Okay, we're gonna pull the puppy back.
This isn't working!
Working fine, shut up. Oh, hello. So this guy's near death. I'm gonna wait for Itamak to be fully healed before we send him back in. Never mind, we're gonna send Itamak in right now. Because otherwise we risk him taking me out of combat. There we go. Another one bites the dust. If we manage to finish this fight off? Oh my goodness. How much time do we have? We have 1 minute left in our timer. So this is going to be the final fight, and we'll just have to hope that we manage to successfully pull it off. Altria! What the hell? She keeps getting targeted. What is going on with that? Stop. I don't know why I'm even pulling him into this room. There's really no strong reason why it's necessary. So let's send Itamak in. Oh, Jesus. Get out of there. He's gonna cast a fireball. What's the alarm? Yikes. So that could have been really bad. But instead it was fine. So he still had a fireball. He's now attacking Itamak, which I do not like, so I'm going to pull Itamak out. Okay. I'm going to try to minimize his AoE potential. He's now attacking Itamak directly again, so I'm just going to pull him out. Okay, he's casting another web. Wow, was that a 15 damage hit? Good job, Itamak. Itamak killed him. Oh my goodness. We just did it. Crumpled at your feet lies the body of a woman. She wears a dark robe that bears an insignia resembling a key. As you approach the woman's body, feelings of rage assault you. The dead woman's face, her voice howls in your ears, and her lingering consciousness rends in yours. Her essence tingles through your bones and membranes. It fills the spaces between your ears, behind your eyes, clawing deeper into your core. You see a gathering of men and women wearing robes like hers, their faces hidden behind masks. One by one, they approach her, whom they know as an acolyte, and she places her hand on each of their foreheads, searching their thoughts. She tests them with ritualistic questions, and they answer that their oath is sealed by the light within the key. She asks them of their tasks. She gives them new ones, all without a word. I'll try to see the tasks. Her essence flares, fighting to boil your blood, burn your memory, and splinter your bones from within. Yet between its strikes, you see flashes of something else, a tower, a prisoner, and a ruin. You funnel all your concentration into a single effort of will, a sharp point that pins the raging soul in place like an insect on a display case. With the thing under control, you're able to examine it into the three thoughts swirling inside. So let's look at the tower. You see a palimpsest of a neighborhood. Rundown estates are cobbled about a cemetery and an ancient tower. Savage shapes prowl the streets, and in the tower, a man hunches over a strange mechanism. You can't see him clearly, but there's something unnatural about him. Somewhere nearby, you see a woman with a scar over her heart. You understand that she has something he needs. Scar over her heart. So, I'm gonna stay. So this is like a slum. An ancient tower. Okay. So you also see a door in the base of the tower, seemingly impenetrable slab of stone and copper, but then the arc light reveals the invisible split between the perfectly matched halves, and you understand how the copper veins convert a command into action. You know how to open the door. Nice. In your mind, you see a building magnificent with trellises and tiles and located in a pristine boulevard. The wealthy and learned stroll in and out, trading knowledge and coin, yet it also houses misery and madness. Somewhere within its rotten core sits a man, his hair matted, but his eyes alert. He watches and waits, a prisoner by choice. Interesting. The Acolyte's vision takes you out of Defiance Bay into a town in the wilderness with a windmill. A signpost on one of the paths reads, Deer Forward. Several figures huddle together, shrouded in cloaks and hoods. An image of ruin suddenly looms in your mind. Two skeletal effigies flank the cleft in the mountainside. Party gained 1980 experience. Total quest experience 3960. The man who waits. The man who saves. Save complete. My party is all alive. And
no problem.
We can loot this stuff up.
Yeah.
I will do the looting before I end the stream. Even though we're a little over time, because waiting half a week to see the next thing is probably not going to be fun for you guys. So let's see. Find scepter, lead key. Okay, we're not going to take the key yet. And Novice's Grimoire. I'm gonna save the game, and that'll be that. We will continue into this room and find out what other tricks are around next time.